Hello, Brian McCarthy here from Bowl and Break. And yes, you are not mistaken, this is the fourth week in a row I've uploaded a video. I can't believe it myself. Let's keep this consistency going. We can do it. I don't know why I'm saying we. It's on me. It's always been on me. I have been the failure, not you guys. You've been great. Okay, let's go. We have this beautiful shoe. It's absolutely gorgeous that we've downloaded from cgtrader.com. Link in the description below. Remember to like and subscribe when you're looking at that description. And comment if you're feeling, you know, like you have any energy left in this world. So we have all these selected. Let's right click, connect objects and delete. And then we want to go into edge mode, which is here. Press Control A to select all your edges. Right click, go down to edge to spline. The spline that has been just created will become a child of the model. Let's turn this off. I wish I was a child of a model. Cool. Now, we go back to our model mode, or our object mode, as some people like to call it. We have this very cool spline. What can we do with this? Lots. But the most obvious thing you can think of is mouse spline. And we can turn this off because we're going to reference this object in mouse spline. And in our mode, object properties, make sure you're in the object panel, go to spline. Then this spline panel will pop up. Drag in your logo.1 spline. Don't ever name things like that. You can, wow. Just mind blown. Cool, so we have this, and there's lots we can do with this. We can add effectors, we can add forces. Mouse spline is a very malleable, there's so much you can do. It is limited in some areas, you know, I've come up against walls against it, but for the most part, brilliant tool for motion graphics. Now, we want to render this in Redshift, so we go to our IPR. Nothing's there. Again, what do you think you have to do? If you've been watching my videos, yes, you are correct, you've guessed it. Object, Redshift, Object Tag. With all these panels, you want to be in the curve panel and you want to change your mode to hair strands. And there we go. There's our splines. Put this to maybe 0.1 and it looks like a tech animation. Very cool. Bring the scale down and you will add less uniformity to your splines. Maybe bring that up to 0.5. That's way too chunky. Maybe 0.2. If we want to, you know, speed it up, we can change the interpolation to fast. It's fast, just like the Nike shoe we have in front of us. Supposing you don't want to be restricted to using your spline in mouse spline, just copy this tag, unhide that, hide your mouse spline. You know, the exact same thing, it's just replaced it. And there's lots you can do with this as well. You know, if you want to add spline dynamics, you can do that. And you can add forces into that animation and you can be very creative, abstract, experiment with this. It's very cool. I will extend this tutorial into, you know, more interesting animations. If you are interested what can be done with this, go check out my Instagram, Breaking the Bold. Remember to like and subscribe. Hopefully we'll have another video up next week and we will be 5 in a row. Can you believe it? I can't. Thank you for watching and goodbye.